everyone. So finally we are live, and right now I'm sitting with the most gorgeous singer, dancer, actor, and what all can I add to it?
Human being.
Oh wow, yes. Human being. A beautiful human being.
Thank you so much.
So welcome to our Facebook Live and Insta Live, Garima.
Hello everybody.
So I think this is your first live chat with us.
Yeah, this is the first live chat. And you know what? It's taken so long to get her because I think every time, you know, I've had anything out, any project, I've gotten like, do a live chat, and finally it's happened.
Definitely so, seems like very confident right now in front of the camera, very camera friendly.
Yeah, I like the camera. Hi guys. Yes. How are you? How is everybody? Chacha chachi, sab theek hai?
Sab badhiya. So now we all know that 3 days ago your song released, Naina Barse Re. So definitely, Naina Barse Kyun. So our viewers are waiting for you to tell them ki matlab kya socha apne, like what was the concept behind it and why this particular song. And we all know that Times Music ke saath you have done one song before, Meherbani, which was a super duper hit, and 3 days mein ye bhi gana bahut hit ho chuka hai. So what do you have to say about the song? Like kaise socha ke, you know, I have to do this song?
Well, you know, like as you said with Times, I did a song Meherbani, and it was so much fun, and it was just great to find, because that was my first single that I was a part of, and it was really cool. It was a very cool process to first start off with a duet.
Correct.
And then now I'm finally getting to do a solo song, so I'm so excited about that. And the way the song came about, it's really nice because it's a team that I've worked with, Naresh Sharma ji, who's a wonderful artist, musician and mentor to me. He and Anand ji, Naresh Anand, composed this really quirky song. So if you look at the song Naina Barse Kyun, it's like the lyrics are very, like they're a little sad, you know, it's ki aankhein bheegi bheegi hain, man khoya khoya. And you read it and you think that this is a really sad song.
Yeah, and first thought is like itna sad, and then you see the video.
Yeah, it's a very up-tempo fun song. So I heard the scratch, which was done in, you know, a male voice. So it was also like, you know, they were thinking, male song banaya, female song banaya, what do we do with it? And I loved it so much. I remember I was like, this song is so cool and so catchy and so quirky.
Yeah.
It's such a happy, sad song.
Correct.
So I was really excited, and so when they asked me to do like to sing a little bit of it, I thought maybe because it was again like a male scratch track, because you know, for every song that's made there's a scratch track, or
yes, definitely,
you know, first draft jaise banate hain. So maine socha ki pata nahi ye, you know, they want me to do little part, little female part, jaise last time duet kiya tha, but luckily they were like, no, I think you should only sing one song. I was so excited. I was
so
like,
happy.
I love this song.
Finally, I'm the one who's doing.
Yeah, and I really, and the zone is so happy and fun, and I was very comfortable with it.
Yeah, we can see in the video, you know, you're jumping and dancing and looking so pretty.
Yeah.
And especially, you know, in the video, we can also literally see your acting skills. So when this concept came up, you were thinking, could you like relate to this song? Ki, yaar, meri life mein bhi kabhi kuch aisa hua, or, you know, with my friends or something. Like, could you relate to the song when you read the lyrics?
I could really relate. Okay, so there are two parts. So I won't say too much about the video because I hope everybody watches it.
Yes.
But there are like two different parts of a breakup. You know, there are two stages, I would say. Ek stage hota hai ye rona dhona wala stage. Ke mere saath naina barse kyun, mere saath kyun ho raha hai. You know that there's a famous scene in Queen where she keeps crying, where she's
yeah,
mera love kharab ho gaya, that kind of a stage. Then the second stage is when you're like, okay, 1 second. The second meaning of Naina Barse Kyun is, Naina Barse Kyun, why am I crying? I should be happy. Mujhe to abhi freedom mila, independence mila. This is amazing. So I could really relate to the second part of it because I'm a very positive person. So I'm the one usually jab mere friends ke koi breakups, sad, you know, sad vibes ho rahe hai, to I'm always the one that's like, come on, enjoy it. I put the positive twist on it. Okay, you know what? It's not so much that he's gone out of your life. It's that you're back in your life. Independent girl power type of a thing. So yeah, I'm very like that. So I was very happy with the second part of the video is very me, upbeat and happy.
So like whenever you're going through bad phase, you know, aapko kiske gaane sunne hain?
Yeah, don't worry about it, because you know what? I would say, you know, even my friends and anybody that's going through a breakup, the most important thing is to feel happy about yourself and confident. Mm-hmm. So I really enjoyed that part of it a lot. I really did. And also there's a great part where I eat a chocolate cake all by myself. Chocolate cake ka scene hota hai. So that was also a lot of
fun. Did you actually like ate that entire cake?
Yes. Yeah, I was hoping ki the jitne retake so utna acha hoga mere liye, because then I have to keep eating cake. And yeah.
भूख लगने लग गई केक की, सो आफ्टर दिस इंटरव्यू मेकिंग मी ईट दैट केक फॉर श्योर. सो नाउ जस्ट यू जस्ट मेंशन राइट नाउ के फ्रेंड्स का या किसी का भी ब्रेकअप होता है, सो यू आर द वन हू चेयर देम अप. सो नाउ वी ऑल नो दैट यू आर अ ब्रिलियंट सिंगर और आप चेयर अप भी करते हो, सो आई वॉन्ट यू टू सिंग दैट वन सॉन्ग जो आप यूज करते हो अपने फ्रेंड्स को या अपने किसी फैमिली मेंबर को चेयर अप करने.
Cheer up करने के लिए so many nice happy songs.
One of your favorites जो सबको हंसा देते हैं, खुश कर देते हैं.
Okay, so there's this. So when I was younger, I used to love, you know, of course, Kareena Kapoor. जब भी met was one of my favorite songs. तो I used to sing this song a lot as a kid, and that's why people keep telling me to sing this song. It's also a very nice happy song about love being very painful. So, should I sing it?
Go ahead, all yours.
Ha, hai koi to wajah, yun jeene ka maza, yun aane laga. Dew-dew-dew-dew, ye, hawaon mein hai kya, thoda sa jo nasha, yun chane laga. Dekho na dekho mujhe kya, hua hai teri baahon mein aakar. देखो ना देखो मुझे क्या हुआ है तेरी सपनों में जीकर. ये इश्क हाय बैठे बिठाए जन्नत दिखाए हाँ ओ रामा. ये इश्क हाय बैठे बिठाए जन्नत दिखाए हाँ.
Wow, amazing, brilliant. I wanted you to stop. And I wanted you to just keep going and going and going. Hi. Now because you've been to singing, so this is one question I think sab jana chahenge. Who inspired you to become, you know, get into singing? Were you confused between ke nahi I should go into singing or some other profession? Or since childhood you were motivated ki, you know, I want to become a singer and you used to listen to some, any particular singer?
You know, I grew up in London actually. So when people say ke, you know, industry wali bachchi or something because of, you know, my buaji, I always feel like actually I grew up very far from the Indian film or music industry. So my influences were lots of like theater, musical theater, and I used to sing a lot of like, oh, like very like Sound of Music and Mamma Mia and all those songs. So fir I always you know, saw Hindustani music as being like sabse difficult music genre. So I was like, I don't want to do this. I'm very comfortable with Western singing and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. So I started off with theatre, and when I shifted to Mumbai, I was like, chalo, let's try Hindi songs. So this is still, it's still new and I'm getting more and more comfortable into it. But yeah, I always wanted to do something in music and acting because main hamesha aise thode like nautanki si thi, like
drama queen.
Yeah,
Kareena Kapoor of jab bhi main.
Yeah. When I was about like 5 years old, you know how there's always that kid that's like the entertainer in the party. So they used to make me say Sevan Kareena Kapoor ka poo wala dialogue from K3G. And I was like 5 years old. I was like, kaun hai wo jisne dobara mujhe nahi dekha? Who is he? Like, you know, all those like poo wale dialogues. So I always knew I want to do something in this field. So, but like Indian, yes. Hindustani music and all is still like was new to me.
Yes, you were like the entertainer of the family and now of our industry.
Yeah, actually like, you know, that's something that Buji and I have in common quite a bit. Like even she's of course very, you know, well respected. She's a very nice, a wonderful legendary singer ka image, but at home she's very fun loving also.
Okay.
Which I think a lot of people see in like these reality shows and all that. She has this very fun loving side of her personality.
Yes, we will definitely talk about your relationship with your bua ji, that is Alka ji. But before that, let's see if we have some questions and we can answer them.
Yes, whatever it is, let's see. I And yeah, I think that also, to in addition to what I was saying, you know, Hindustani music nowadays, Indian music and Western music is so connected.
Yes.
So I'm really enjoying that there's a nice blend happening nowadays. So yeah.
So are you planning to do it?
The blend? Hi, okay, hi Garima, yes. Your track is unique. Hello Abhishek Sharma, thank you. Thank you for your nice comments.
Yeah, we have Iftiar Ali, we have Unique
Ramali. You're from Nepal. Hello Nepal. I love to hear where you're from. So whoever's watching, if you just say ki aap kahan se ho, I'd love to give you a shout out because it's lovely to see where we're reaching.
Look who's here, right behind you.
Hello.
How are you?
Are you?
So guys, finally the wait is over.
So are we already on the?
Yes, yes, of course.
Everybody,
come, please. Hello, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Yeah, please have a seat. You can come.
And sit.
Yes. Garima could have sat in my lap, but she's grown up now.
But still, I don't think she's that heavy. You can manage.
She's all fit. So finally guys, Alka ji is here and she doesn't need any introduction. And finally her cute niece has already debuted with Times Music with Meher Mali song. Now it's Naina Barse Kyun. I'm sure Alka ji must have heard her song Naina Barse Kyun.
Yes, I have heard it. Definitely.
So like a proper, are you gonna criticize her like about the video? Did you criticize her? Did you tell her what the video is? What is?
If I had to criticize her, I'm not gonna do it on camera. I'll do it in person, privately.
Yes. So jokes apart, but how?
Because
there is
actually nothing much to criticize about.
Yes, definitely.
But
I
of
think
course, a little bit.
Family has to be honest.
Has to be there so that she can get better and better.
Yeah, so how did you find her video? How did you like it? Was it any different from her first album?
It's lovely. It's very. She's full of energy. She's as it is a very, you know, the video is full of bounce and energy and punch and it's a very vivacious and a very bright video.
Correct.
And she sung it beautifully also in her own style.
Yes.
And it's cute. It's a very happy video and it's a pleasure to watch it.
Correct. So since childhood, she used to come to you ke, please mera gana suno, mujhe gana sikhao.
Nahin, gaati thi, itna mujhe, itna zyada kuch nahi bolti thi, gana sikhao. In fact, she probably wanted my mom to, because my mom has taught me. So she probably wanted my mom to teach her as well, her grandmother. But grandmother was, she was not inclined towards teaching.
I think also it was the opposite. I was very scared also of singing Hindi songs, if you remember.
Yeah, but
I used to be like very scared of singing.
No, also. And I remember that she was a little girl and that song of mine had released Taal Se Taal Mila.
Yes.
So she used to tell her, Garima gaao na, ke singing gaana gaao. So she used to say, Taal Se Taal Mila. She used to pull that taal and sing it like that, you know. So, yeah. And she was always a performer.
Always.
She was always jumping here and
yeah,
there.
Yeah, we can see her, your image in her.
My image? Wow. No, I'm very quiet as compared to her. I mean, or rather like she is totally, she's not camera conscious at all.
Yeah.
I have always been camera conscious and still am.
But when we see you on stage doing any concert or awards, doesn't look like that you're an introvert person or you're shy.
No, but you know, the stage gives me a high and it kind of brings out the child and the naughtiness and the mischief in me. And when there's a live audience in front of me and I connect with them, bond with them, talk to them, then I'm a different person.
And
but off stage, I'm a different person.
And there's something like growing up and watching her perform since I was a little kid. There's something
we all have.
Yeah, there's something that I take for granted, which I noticed just recently, that she has this, you have this thing, she comes on stage and everybody's just like, is she going to do that? Stage presence is something that's like,
no, and it's a very, I don't know, some way I feel that people are a little kind of wary of me, you know, because when I come on stage, they kind of are a little thoda sa kus 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 hota, and when I'm singing, they are kind of trying to behave themselves. But I always tell them, I say, listen, because I've been in the industry for the last 35 years, they think they probably.
Out of respect, you know.
Yeah, but I just listen. Let yourself loose. Sing, dance, whistle, scream, shout. Yeah. I love that. And then there's no stopping them.
They're thinking, Alka ji, you know, kuch bolna de, kuch gadbad na ho jaye.
She's observed me since childhood on stage. So
yeah.
She's always been like very comfortable on stage and in front of the camera also.
And I'll tell you a very interesting thing. People didn't know. So when I moved here, when I was a teenager, then people thought I was very angrez, you know, because I had a little bit of an accent then and stuff. So they were like, oh, she doesn't know anything about Bollywood. And people didn't know about the collection. So school mein, someone, ironically, this song, they were just like, you don't know anything about Bollywood. You're from London. Tell me, like, what song is this? Mohini. Mohini. I was like, hold on. I did the entire namaskar. I did that whole thing and sang the whole song, and I was like,
"Would ever say an accent?"
Yeah, I was like, "Would ever say
an accent?" It's like that scene in Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, na, when Raju Mukherjee is told to sing that
song on the stage.
Do line na aur mishlok ka.
Wo wala ha.
Jagdish Hare, and they say, "Arey kya gaya? Ye to abroad se aayi." But then she breaks into it, and everybody's shocked that oh, she can actually.
Bas, bhai, sanskaron ki baat hai.
I was like, "Don't say that. I don't know Bollywood."
Yeah.
Also,
we can take a few questions.
So, yes, a lot of people who are waiting for you, and they've been asking Garima questions. Naz is saying, who would you say is your inspiration for your love of music and why? So I suppose that's good.
She's asking you.
Both of them.
I think they're asking you now, Garima.
Mine, everybody knows Lata Mangeshkar is mine.
Of course, Buji is of course an inspiration that I've grown up with. No, but seriously, of course.
She's right. But what though inspiration
in the sense that also she's so high up there in terms of my respect that I can't
I'm not high up, I live down.
Because I can't even begin to think that way, because I she's the ultimate artist according to me, so she's definitely an inspiration. I also love I love a lot of Western artists. I love Ariana Grande right now. I love old music. I love Frank Sinatra. I love Kishore Kumar. Who doesn't love Kishore Kumar? Is like also according to me the perfect voice. So yeah,
any more questions we can take?
Yeah, Arman was saying, although I don't see it right now, Arman was saying, is it possible to be a singer without any struggle? I read.
Well, is this for me?
I mean,
what do you say?
I say
actually,
absolutely not.
There is no way anyone can become
anything without
to achieve a place or to make a name without struggle. But different people have different kinds of struggle. Like some people come here into the city penniless, and they have to, for them to, even before they make a career, they have to make ends meet, and they have to struggle, and they have to walk miles and miles. A lot of people are artists who are
correct,
who have come up, they come up the hard way. Then there are different kind of struggles, like I think we never had, even me as a child and even she as a child, we didn't have that kind of struggle because parents are very supportive,
correct.
And that cushioning, that protection was given, and it was like with their permission and with their strength, their support, I went ahead also, and she went ahead also. So that kind of struggle was not there. But then, of course, you have to struggle to better yourself. Then there's so many artists in the field, and every day there are new coming up.
Yes.
So to make in that jungle, to make a little den of your own, a little place of your own, you have to struggle. It's an everyday trying to get better than yesterday.
Yeah, definitely.
And
yeah,
just
yeah,
from
yeah,
my
yeah,
I think it's in every field. When
yeah,
you're single,
yeah, that's
actor,
true. And that's in every field. That's
everyone,
in every field.
Yes.
From my Itana's experience that I have started out with, I'd also like to add that it's impossible, especially in any field, of course, without struggle. But the less you think of it as a struggle, if you can, the better it is for you. It's a process. And you need to go through it, and it's very difficult. There are distractions and there's people that will look down on you and everything, but you know I also find that, you know, is field mein people say, even for acting, you know, okay, oh, she's a struggler, you're a struggler, waise, and that is demotivating. So I hate that term, and people have said that about me also, you know, shayad.
But people are
so they thing talk. Is less you think of it as struggling, it's not struggling, it's beautiful, it's very nice, and keep doing it.
You have to take all this with a pinch of salt.
Yeah.
It's okay. Yeah. Let them say, yeah,
yeah,
I'm struggling. I'm really struggling. So let me struggle.
Maza aana chahiye.
बस वही है. और
आई थिंक स्ट्रगल में मजा ही कुछ और होता है. यू गेट टू लर्न सो मेनी थिंग्स यू नो, यू ग्रो एज अ पर्सन.
ट्रू,
बिकॉज़ व्हेन यू गेट दैट
एंड थिंक यू वैल्यू व्हाट यू अचीव.
करेक्ट.
एंड विद व्हाट इज गुड अबाउट विद इन हर केस, शी इज मल्टी
टैलेंटेड.
कैन डांस, शी कैन सिंग, शी कैन एक्ट. सो कहीं ना कहीं यू नो शी फिट्स इनटू एवरी मोल्ड. सो द फील्ड इज वाइडर, मोर वाइडली ओपन फॉर.
यस डेफिनेटली, वो तो है.
Shari Sun says I love you.
Oh,
so many people are saying no. We love you too.
I listen to.
Garima loves you too.
और हमें एक Instagram पे भी question आया है ध्वनि कृष्ण से. उन्होंने send किया है that I love both of you. I've seen your new song Garima. It's amazing and it's like continuously it's in my shuffle list. I keep listening to it. And she's saying कि आप दोनों एक साथ कब, when can we see both of you together, like doing a song or a concert or anything? We would love to see you together.
Yeah, we have actually done a little small thing here and there.
Yeah.
But we definitely, whenever there's scope to do that, we will definitely come on stage together. I mean, it's just that it has to be the right time and things should fall into place. We are always open to it. In fact, we are also open to doing a single together or an album together. But somebody has to come with the right kind of blend, because I have a different kind of style, she has a different kind of style, and something that can incorporate both the styles.
Yes.
And blend it beautifully, you know, to make it interesting. Otherwise, there's no point just doing anything.
One of the I joined her on stage once, which was one of the coolest moments of my life, because. Ek Do Teen we did.
Yeah.
And it was like I've grown up hearing Ek Do Teen, obviously.
We also did a reality show together where it was great fun. Because we are quite similar in the sense that we are both fun loving and we like a little bit of mischief and a little bit of, you know, that. But of course she is more relaxed in front of the camera. I'm a little reticent.
Okay, now you're saying that you did went for the Antakshri or aap jeete bhi, to isi pe hum ek game khelenge with both of you.
Oh,
and it's a very interesting game. We'll win again.
Hamper hai, to hi khelenge,
hum bhi khelenge. Hai na hamper. Wo main jab game khatam ho jayegi then I'll give you a surprise. That what the hamper is all.
Mug mat de dena.
Are nahi better.
Just kidding.
Better. Okay. Water.
Let's go.
Women.
So the game is कि मैं अलका जी की मूवी जो उन्होंने जिस दिन मूवीज में गाने गाए हैं, सो आई विल नेम आई से अ नेम ऑफ द मूवी, सो यू हैव टू सिंग अ सॉन्ग ऑफ अलका जी फ्रॉम दैट मूवी.
ओके, ये
करेंगे.
अलका जी आपको भी गाना चाहिए.
मैं गाना नहीं, मैं इसको कुछ कुछ करके बता दूंगी. के शी डजंट रिमेंबर.
नो 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 नो
नो नो नो
नो ठीक है. So let's start. Are you guys ready? So first movie is Kuch Kuch Hota Hai.
Tum paas aaye, yun muskuraye, tumne na jaane kya sapne dikhaye. Ab to mera dil jaage na sota hai, kya karu haaye, kuch kuch hota hai. क्या करूँ हाय कुछ कुछ होता है.
नेक्स्ट मूवी मोहरा.
व्हाट
जितना भी
की धड़कनों को समझो, तुम भी मुझसे प्यार कर लो, ला 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 ला
ला. Next is one of your favorites, Zakhm.
One of my favorites.
Zakhm. Pooja.
अरे
पूजा
ये क्या है? अरे मून दिखा रही हो पागल.
ओ गली में आ चांद निकला. हां यस आई न्यू दैट. आई वाज जस्ट टेस्टिंग यू.
सी सी अच्छा
अच्छा वो बस आपकी टेस्ट ली थी
क्योंकि अल्लाह जी ने इतने सारे गाने गाए तो मे बी हो सकते हैं वो भी शायद कहीं भूल ना गई हो.
बट दिस
वन यू कैन सिंग. तुम आए तो आया मुझे यार गली में आ चांद निकला जाने कितने दिनों के बाद गली में आ चांद निकला जाने कितने दिनों के बाद गली में आ चांद निकला गली में आ चांद निकला गली में आ चांद निकला तुम आए तो आया मुझे यार गली में आ चांद निकला.
To stop, I just want to keep singing and singing. Last movie, Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham.
Dekha tumko jab se, bas dekha tumko yara. Tumse koi acha hai na, tumse koi pyara. Yun nazare na phero tum, mere ho mere tum. Keh do na, you are my Sonia.
Keh diya, you are my Aww. Sonia.
Karan uncle, is there any you know song in the film that's ready? And then he was like, okay, I'll show you this this song. It's called You Are My Sonia. It's Buji's song, and you're the first kid to see it.
Wow.
And I remember I was so excited, and I saw it, and I fell
How
in
old were you?
Love with it. I don't know, must have been 8, 7, 8. Like I was very young.
I might be doing
all those things.
The background pieces,
so,
I guess.
And he was like, here, and he, I remember he told me, as he was like, you're the first person in the world to see this song ready.
Wow.
And I was so excited in that Kareena and the red outfit and all. So this all is so special to me.
So you're like, I wish I was there. You know, maybe red costume, maybe felt like dancing after hearing that song.
Yeah, this is, that's ultimate.
Okay, so we'll take some more questions because people have been sending a lot of questions to you and Alkaji. So let's take a few more questions.
This is moving so fast.
Yeah, just click on comments. Yeah.
Are
you? Click comment, no?
Huh?
Comment on that.
No, no, it's 204. Let's see, it's not showing. How come?
Sure, sure, I'll see. I'll check.
Okay, I would like to ask you a question.
Go ahead.
What was the best experience while recording a song? Like, which song do you remember that you, when recording, like you had the most like fun, that you always remember that recording session?
I can't sing aloud one song. There's so many songs I've sung and enjoyed a lot of them. Not that. I mean, I can't remember this one particular song which I enjoyed singing.
Okay.
When we used to do live recordings, it was fun because you know, for duets, we jab gaate the, the male and the female singer used to be singing them together in one room, which we don't do now.
Hmm.
Now it's they dub the song separately. The female singer comes, dubs a portion, the male singer comes, and they do.
Hmm.
We used to do live recording, both the mic used to be next to each other, we both used to be singing with each other.
Hmm.
And then it was fun because, you know, it was like there was a lot of repartee, you know, in the thing. Like, like if I have sung something, then the male singer has to feel, okay, now let me add something to this so that I sound better than her.
Yeah.
So then when he sang, then I felt, okay, let me now sing better than him. So that little undercurrent of little competition that used to go on, it was great fun.
Yeah.
Then used to laugh later on that, see, I did that because you did that. So, you know, it was like that. So those live recordings used to be fun, but otherwise...
And natural also.
Natural
sure,
also.
Huh?
And the flow of the song used to come well because it used to... The
yeah.
music, the, then the chorus, and then the solo lines, and then it seems to go in one flow.
Yeah, that's what I really like about live stuff, because like when I do the show,
yeah.
So sorry for all those that don't know, I'm doing a musical also right now, a live musical,
yeah.
Called Balle Balle with Wistraft. So every time when
yeah.
I do a show, it's so cool because like you were saying, we kind of get a glimpse into that experience of doing everything on the spot. Because you know when you're singing and you're acting and you're dancing and everything is happening, like sometimes you do things that you don't expect also.
And
you know, you're singing
instant,
and you're doing...
You get an instant reaction from the audience.
Yeah,
that's a very...
A lot of fun, yeah.
Actually, there's a net issue, so we're not able to take questions from here. A lot of people are actually sending the questions. They're already like 300. Some net issues. I'll also check.
But yeah, also in the comments,